Morning, Scaniacs. That's my new terminology for you guys. I decided I was going to try out a few different things and see if something stuck. So I came up with that one this morning. I'm also trying out vlogging for the first time. So we have some fun plans this weekend, including a jaunt over to one of my local yarn stores. And I thought it would be fun to bring you guys along and just give you a bit of a peek into our everyday lives, our weekend lives anyway. So stick around if that sounds interesting to you, and I hope this will add some additional color to my channel and give you some more fun insight, and hope you enjoy it. So I just woke up and took my shower and put on a little bit of makeup, and now I'm gonna head downstairs and get dressed and make start the laundry and then make lunch for us, actually, because we did a wee bit of sleeping in today and then we just spent some time in bed in the morning because it is Saturday and we're pretty excited about it because my husband is off and he lately has been working like 2 out of 3 weekends at the hospital. So yeah, let's see what we get up to today. Outfit check. I have on store-bought socks today because I'm going to be wearing some Chuck Taylors. So they're just little ankle socks from Madewell, but I think they're cute. Black jeans, J Brand, Everlane cashmere sweater, and little Emilio Pucci scarf that I got years and years ago. And messy French braided hair because I probably should have washed it this morning, but I just didn't because I'm gross, you guys. And this behind me is Ryan's bookshelf, that his bookcases that I talked about us organizing. So I thought I'd show you a little bit of that since I talked about the process. So this is all fiction and then music over here. Or actually there's a couple on language and then music. So these are some small sections here. And then this is all Game of Thrones. Have some of the larger ones down here. These are his CDs. Obviously, we have mostly digital music, but there are some CDs that he wanted to keep. And then 33 and a third books, which are small little books about individual albums. And then we have memoirs and biographies, a small little humor section. Those are our nephews at our wedding. Aren't they great? They're 3 years older than that now. It's crazy how big they are now. Journalism, sort of fun facts type books. He has a lot of those. Small religion section, science. And this entire shelf is graphic and it's organized with comic strips into graphic novels, into graphic nonfiction, into trades. And then he has coffee table books and textbooks down here. And then we have a bunch of stuffed animals up here and a Dr. Pepper lunchbox because we're adults. Now this entire case is history. The first shelf has general history. These are about more of a smaller, like, specific thing that happened in history, if that makes sense. And or like a specific subject matter. And these are organized chronologically, and they go into this section as well. And then these are all micro histories, which if you don't know what a micro history is, it's like a very specific topic, and then you get a good idea of everything about it. So these are what I referred to as sort of like a text from the time. So these are the actual writings of people in history, sort of like historical documents. And this is Rome. And then we have our board games and some DVDs. Ryan is actually running a couple errands right now. He's run down to our local garden shop to see if he can find some seed packs and a hoe and a tiller and some things that he needs to kind of fix up the front yard and put a little wildflower patch in where we've just got some weeds at the moment. So he'll be back in a minute and you'll meet him. Are you waiting for Daddy to come home? Are you waiting for Daddy? Okay, Daddy be home soon.
I went to the market, though it was threatening rain. I was late to the station, so I missed that train. And the streets filled with umbrellas, and we all look the same. But I'm the one who's waiting till the sun comes out again. I say, I was made for sunny days. I may do it great, but I didn't stay.
A weasel?
Yeah.
Oh, I get it, because they like dig.
You twist, you stab it in and then twist.
Fun.
And I won't put that outside.
Okay.
I got. I got seeds. The guy has like a whole pack. He said this will cover 400 square feet. So that's like totally enough. And we have to germinate it.
Greg's Garden Woodland Edge Ohio Native Seed Mix. That's awesome.
Yeah. And then I also asked him if I could get some catnip, and he gave it to me like this, like I'm some fucking kind of drug dealer.
That's awesome.
And
this is our local store here, Northside Range.
And I got this, which is a local artist graphic memoir that they had at Shake It Records.
You want to shake it?
Yeah, and they had like 9 copies of them. I said, why do you have so many copies? He said, they have a clasp on it at DAP.
Oh, neat. That's really cool.
And then I got this for you from the
library. You're with the library. Thank you so much. Yay.
And I got some guitar strings, because I took that one string off to play that Christmas song.
Right. Awesome. They have those at Shake It. I was gonna say the music store closed. How did you get yarn?
I was made for sunny days. I may do it great, but I didn't stay. I was made for sunny days, and I was made for you. Found the look you gave me when we were first in.
Yesterday it was 70 degrees. Our tree out front started blooming, you can see it there. And we went for a walk in short sleeves and flew a kite in the park. And right now it is snowing.
Sunny days, I may do it great, but I didn't stay. I was made for sunny days.
Sit down and have our lunch, and it is plated salmon burgers with raita and caramelized cauliflower. Yum!
Left behind everything I knew, all the colors but bone white and sky blue. Hit the continent running, engines were humming just to break through. Can't wait anymore.
local yarn store. I had never been to that one before, and I saw online that they carried Quince & Co., which is awesome, but they actually don't have Owl, which is the worsted wool base that I need for the Floam cardigan. So apparently they've been trying to get Quince & Co. to let them carry it, but you know, some companies are just really strict about that sort of thing. They want to keep it close to the vest or whatever. I don't really know why. I'm not going to try to explain business models. I didn't go to business school. I barely understand what business is. So that happened. And then we just went to Half Price Books, and this guy over here got a bunch of books. And he had
10 books.
And Ryan, tell me, had you ever been to Half Price Books before?
No, somehow.
Somehow he had never been to Half Price Books before, and like, he's like me, like we're both big readers. I think at this point he's an even bigger reader than I am. So, I mean, you guys saw his bookshelf. We've talked about it. You know, y'all know. So yeah, so that was fun. So now we're gonna go to dinner at one of our favorite restaurants, which is a pie place. I'm very passionate about pie. And I am in a few days going to embark on a 6-week vegan journey for Lent. I'm going completely vegan for Lent, which means that I'm not going to be eating at that restaurant or eating much in the way of pie. So gotta have my little last hurrah with that. And we might go to a little weird Quentin Tarantino themed speakeasy later as well, because that's a thing that we have in Cincinnati. Cincinnati's cool, right? Cincinnati's not cool. We're super lame. Nobody should move here and make our property prices go up at all. Like, we're totally lame and we don't have Quentin Tarantino themed speakeasies. Or like a bunch of local yarn stores at all. It's not a thing we have. We don't have like 5 record stores. We're not cool. Yeah. Anything else to add, Ray? Okay. Back at home, as you probably saw, we picked up Ryan's brother after dinner and headed to the Tarantino speakeasy, and then we went back to his place and watched Silence of the Lambs, because I had never seen it before, and he owns like every movie, and because of the whole like faux video front, it was just making us in the mood to see a movie. Plus there were like movies playing in there. So we went back to our version of a blockbuster, which is Ezra's apartment, and watched a movie, and now it's very late. So Ryan's going to show me all the cool books that he found today, and then we're going to go to sleep. So I will see you in the morning. Good night. Ivy, are you checking out the Half Price Books haul? What do you think? Pretty groovy, huh? Pretty groovy. Good morning. It's Sunday and we've just been having a bit of a lazy morning in bed, reading a little bit. And now we're going to go and do some kind of surprise that Ryan has planned for me that I don't know what it is. And hopefully I will have time after that in the afternoon to record the podcast. If I don't, then you'll just be getting the vlog this week to hold you over, and I'll be recording next weekend. Or I might find a weekday that I can, but I doubt that I'll have the light too in the evening. And then tonight we are going to watch the Oscars at an Oscars party that is at our local sort of indie type cinema that's just down the street for us. And we go there every year and it's lots of fun. So I will bring you along a little bit and see what we get up to today. Outfit check. I have rubber Chelsea boots from Target, same black jeans, and my Kodo sweater that I finished knitting about a month ago with a little stripy tank layered underneath it. And we're ready to go.
Sunday morning brings the dawn in. It's just a restless feeling by my side. Early dawning Sunday morning, it's just the wasted years so close behind. Watch out, the world's behind you. There's always someone around you who will call. It's nothing at all. Sunday morning.
Hey, you're familiar spot, right? Well, I'm about to record the podcast. Ryan and I just got back from an afternoon, as you saw, of seeing some of our favorite landmarks in the city and brunching and riding the streetcar for the first time, which was just put in a few months ago. Well, it was just opened a few months ago. It took a while to lay down the tracks, obviously. So that was lovely. And now I'm going to record the podcast and then we're going to take off and do the Oscars party.
Told us where we stand, and Flash Gordon was there in silver underwear.
Wow. So we just got home and it's really late, so I'm gonna wash my face and go to bed. And yeah, if you were watching the Oscars, or you know, live in the world and have read anything on the internet, then you know why I'm a little bit in shock right now. Wow. So it's been a long day and I'm gonna go to sleep, and that just happened. That was crazy. That was super crazy. Two wonderful movies. Very happy for Moonlight and very disappointed for the people who had to think that they won and then didn't, and for the people who had to win under circumstances of not knowing if they were really winning and not really getting time to give their speeches. And that was super crazy. That was super crazy. This year just keeps messing with us. Just keeps coming. Yeah, but a really great show. I thought it was really great. I thought Kimmel did a really good job. And and a lot of really wonderful, deserving people and films won, and it was a great broadcast. It was just, the end was so shocking. I've never seen anything like that. It kind of like makes me squirm with discomfort just thinking about what that was like for everyone. So it's gonna be a weird after party for them. Okay, I'm gonna go to sleep now. I'm very tired. Thanks for spending the weekend with me. Let me know if you like the vlogging, and I will do it some more sometime, you know, just kind of occasionally. All right. Good night, everybody.